Alright, this is a tutorial on how to diagnose and repair or replace the hard drive in a Boss br-1180 digital recording studio. So, the biggest thing is diagnosing it. If you get the message that says HDD error or drive busy, that it's just that simple. The drive is busy, this is clogged up. So you're going to need to erase it or initialize it. If you can't back up your data and initialize it, you're going to have to initialize it and you're going to lose all your data. If you can't do that and the 10 track keeps freezing up and you have to pull the plug on the back to shut it off, you're going to need to replace this. How to replace this is not as complicated as I first thought, because over the past couple of days I've been pulling my hair out and I really want to help some people out. So I'm going to grab the camera and I'm going to bring this guy over here. Very easy. The hard drive is underneath here when you flip this over. I'm not going to flip it over and take it out because it's just a waste of time. It's very, very easy. It's very self-explanatory. It's a black piece of metal on the bottom. Once you take it out, it's sitting right there, and it's sitting face up like this. There's going to be a housing on this side and housing on that side. Once you take that out, you'll be able to take them off, take the hard drive completely off of it. Before you can remove from the 10 track, you're going to have this foam up here, and this foam rips away. It's sticky on the other side, so you got to be a little bit careful, but you got to be kind of brutal with it. Once you take that off, you can pop these out and everything. Now, what did I do to replace it? Yeah, you can call Boss and you can get the Max Tour, the regular 20 gig or a 40 gig or even an 80 gig. But they're gonna charge you a good price and they're gonna charge you shipping, and it's gonna take you like a month to get it. And then you still have to install it and all of that, which is really, really tits and diesel. It's real easy. So what I did, I went out and I bought, and I just looked at this. It's a desktop hard drive. I thought it was, I've been going off the information that I should get a laptop hard drive. Well, anyways, there you go. 500 gigabytes desktop. Cost me about $150. Brought it home, flipped it over, took the back off, took this out, and put the other one in. Now, when I took this out, one of the technical aspects of it is right up at the top here, the buses, and they give you the specifications on the back for master, slave, jumper, component, and whatnot. But on the ones that are going to come out of the 10 track, you're going to get 2, 4, 6, 8 double slots in one single slot. I know it's really hard to see it in there, but on this one right here, there are 10. Instead of the single one at the end, there's 2. So where this one, you can only put it right there, and there's actually covered by my finger, and you can't see it because of the camera quality, there's a single peg right there. On this one right here, there's 10. So it goes 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So I originally took it out, drew a small schematic of this on a piece of paper, and then tried to match it up with this one, which pretty much looks the same on the back. But just like I said, this is a little bit different right in here. So once I figured that out and put it in, I mean, it was fine. We're talking literally, I put it in, I shut it off, I turned it on, and it... And I could probably do it right now. I'm saving nothing. We'll shut it down. And then we'll turn it back on. And this is the screen I was getting before. It wouldn't come past this. And this light wouldn't blink. And it wouldn't do this. See how it's loading? That's your key right there. That should start on almost anything you do. Initializing, backup, anything. That should be there. If that's not happening in a few seconds, your hard drive is frozen and you need to replace it. And it is very, very easy. It's just like I said, you just turn this over, you pop it out. It's going to be in there, faced like that. You're going to have to take the housing off, pop the styrofoam, pop these two, and you're going to have to, like this one, I have two of these, so this one goes into the 10 track, and this one right here, you have to rip all of this off to take this off, because you want this to stay on. A lot of the hard drives don't come with this, I think it's called an IDE patch or whatever, or cord, but this right here is your money, so just be careful of this. Oh, and another big thing too,
Why is the foam on there? It's resonance. What is resonance? There are certain components in the 10 track that will hum and vibrate and can do damage to this on a, it, not like that, but on another level. So what you want to do is you want to get an old mouse pad and you want to cut it and just in a thin strip, and you want to put it right around here, even just tuck it underneath there and put it, put the housing down on it. So you're going to put like one piece up here, and I cut a real thick strip and put it like this and put it back in the 10 track, put the black on it, sealed it up with the screws, turned it over, put the power in, and we're good to go. If that doesn't happen, like seriously, ask me the question, leave me a question on this video. I don't care how technical it is, I'm going to help you out. Because man, I am not the most technical person in the world, but it really isn't that hard. It seems way more intimidating than it actually is to fix some of this stuff. I hope I've helped somebody. Again, this is a 500 gigabyte, and this is only 20 gigabytes. I petitioned this to 8 petitions at 20 gigabytes. So there's still technically in here right now, there's 340 gigabytes that I'm probably never going to use. But as you can see, I've got 53 hours right there on petition A. So I have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So I have 160 gigabytes on 8 different. And if this took me about 6 months to fill up before I'd have to back it up with how active I am with music, I'm not going to have to fix or change this unless I drop it or damage it or pull the plug out in the back here for probably a very long time. So if you're wondering what's compatible, I guess I just found out almost anything. A desktop hard drive. The other thing too, if you look at the size of the one that comes out of the 10 track, it's 17 millimeters this way. In inches, that's like 0.667. Now, the one that I got and put in here, this one right here, is at least an inch thick, and it fit in here. It didn't look like it was gonna, but it fit in there. So there you go. And again, boss 0, me 1. Fuck you, boss.